everyone, and welcome back to the Chase Media Channel. Today we're going to be flying from Asuncion Airport to Buenos Aires Airport. This flight is going to take us about 2 hours to complete. Today we're going to be flying on VATSIM network, although there will be no ATC available for us at this time right now. And we're going to be using a Microsoft Flight Simulator provided ATC as of now, and we're going to be also using the FS2 crew as a for assistant for our flight for today. We're going to be using a real-time weather and a real-time world time. With that being said, let's jump right into the cockpit and start setting up for our flight. So let's start setting up.
Roger.
Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead. Yeah, battery should be first, and then ground power. Emergency lights are on and parking brakes are set. Let's wait for the aircraft to initialize. Okay, let's go ahead and load up our plan on the tablets here. Very good. And now we can go ahead and request the fuel truck to come and fuel us up. Okay, so okay, select that, set payload and set fuel, and let's select the CRT as well. Request flight plan. Let's see that in the tab, the iPad is downloaded our plan too. Yeah. All right, so root uplink is ready. Let's load it up. Root uplink is loading up. Okay, root uplink is ready. Let's activate it. All right. So, for the zero fuel weight is going to be 50.9, and planned fuel that's going to be 12.4, and for the reserve. All right. And for I'm gonna. Okay, so for the reserves, that's gonna be, let's set it to 2. The cost index for today's flight, that's gonna be 58, and the cruising altitude will be 24,000 24,000 feet. All right, and the average one will be at 260 degrees at 28 knots. There we have a temperature deviation. That's gonna be a plus two. That's mean. Plus 12. So that's gonna be a 32 and minus 12. So it's gonna get us to minus 20 degrees there. Let's set hit execute for this one. Takeoff. We're gonna be expecting flaps 5 for takeoff, CG to 2.9 and departure. So as for the departure, we're gonna be expecting to be departed from runway 20. So departure runway 20 via ITAP. Okay, ITAP transition Assetti. Let's hit execute for that, and that's gonna be expected VSPs. We're gonna revisit them shortly. And as for the approach, we're gonna be expecting an ILS Zulu approach to runway 35. ILS Zulu approach. And we're gonna be coming via Pegon 7X Star, and transition will be custom. All right, let's hit execute there and continue. All right, let's just enter our last known position there, so all the instruments will align. Very good. Back to the EFB here. So we're going to be departing runway 20. Import from the aircraft. Import from no meter data available for that station. Okay.
Hi, the security and safety check are all done. Are we good to start boarding?
Yes.
Thanks.
All right, let's start the boarding procedures. Yeah, boarding is requested, and also let's look at some catering services as well. And now we should have done it before that, but request catering services. Yeah. Do we have an ATIS available for us here?
Ascension airport information, uniform 1000 Zulu. Wind calm.
Calm.
Visibility, tree. Sky condition, few clouds at 1,800 feet, few clouds at 18,900 feet. Temperature, 2 degrees. Dew point, 10. Altimeter 29er, decimal 91. ILS Alpha Runway 20 in use. Landing and departing runway 20. VFR aircraft say direction of flight. All aircraft read back hold short instructions. Advise controller on initial contact you have uniform.
What we said wrong. Insufficient information.
Ascension airport information. Victor 1000 Zulu. Wind calm. Visibility, tree. Sky condition. Few clouds at 1,800 feet, few clouds at 18,900 feet. Temperature, 2 degrees. Dew point, 10. Altimeter 29er, decimal 901. ILS Alpha Runway 20 in use. Landing and departing runway.
Okay, shut up. What we are doing this wrong? So it's gonna be, should be a 00, then double two. Okay, insufficient information data, one more field. All right, let's see what we missed. More fields, missing. What, you know what? about 20 degrees. But we're not gonna be using that then. Let's see RV speeds. Okay, so the path should be V246. That's gonna be good. Okay, so V2 will be 146 for the heading. We're gonna be flying. We're gonna set it to the runway heading in case we're gonna need to fly the runway heading, which is 206 right there. And the final course, we're also gonna set it to 206. Okay, and we're gonna set it on both sides, so my side 206 and the first officer side also gonna be 206. All right, and flight directors are on. Mine is master, he's a slave. Auto throttle is armed. VNAV and LNAV are armed as well. Very good. Let's move on to the radio. So at Ascension Airport, we have had the 80s at 127 decimal 6.
I'm back. No issues on the walk around.
Very good. So our first officer is back as well. So at Buenos Aires Airport, the 80s will be at 127 decimal 8. So 127 decimal 8 on standby there. All right, this one we would like to turn it on, this one. And in case we're gonna need to come back to Ascension Airport, that is gonna be we're gonna be using an ILS approach back to Ascension in case we're gonna need to return for some unexpected reason. So for the localizer there, we're gonna set it to 109 decimal 5. All right, set it to active, and we're gonna set it on this other side as well, 109 decimal 50 for the localizer frequency there. At Buenos Aires Airport, we're gonna be expecting an ILS approach to runway, ILS Zulu approach to runway 5. So Buenos Aires.
Pull up. Wind shear. Wind shear. Wind shear. Terrain. Terrain.
All right.
Pull up.
And the frequency for Buenos Aires, that's going to be 108 decimal 7. So let's set on both sides this terrain frequency as
pull
well.
Up. Don't sink. Don't sink. Too low. Terrain.
And we
too
can
low
also go ahead and request our clearance. So since on ground, request clearance.
Chase 1 ready to copy IFR clearance to Azaiza.
2500. Chase 1 cleared to Azaiza Airport as file.
500.
Takeoff runway 20 climb and maintain 12,000 feet.
300.
Departure frequency is 124.1 squawk
5501. 50. 40, 30, 20, 10.
Wind shear, wind shear, wind shear. Too low, terrain.
Chase 1, did you copy?
Yes.
Chase 1 cleared to Azaiza Airport as filed. Takeoff runway 20 climb and maintain 12,000 feet. Departure on 124.1 squawk 5501.
Case 1 read that correct. Contact ground on 121.9. Good day.
Hi, here's a fuel slip.
Thanks.
Welcome. Have a nice flight.
What the hell? I see the VOD sim has changed the way you file the flight plans. What the? Why is that this way? Okay, so the boarding is complete. But people files like names. That's weird. Let's see. Copy this route, maybe. I don't like the new way that we create a. Can we like file a flight plan, import? You know what, we're not gonna find the network, I think. I'm gonna check that one later. They changed the way we file the flight plans. So let's go ahead and disconnect. Okay, so we disconnected from the VATSIM. And the boarding is completed. We have the catering services still active. Okay, so let's do the pre-flight checklist. Okay, pre-flight checklist.
Pre-flight checklist.
Oxygen.
Tested 100%.
Tested 100%. Navigation transfer and display switches. Normal. Auto. Windows heat on. Pressurization mode selector. Auto. Flight instruments.
Heading 183. Altimeter 1012 set.
Heading 183. Altimeter 1012. Parking brake.
Set.
Engine start levers.
Idle detained. Cut off.
Pre-flight checklist completed.
Okay, that's gonna be a good time to start our departure briefing. So that's gonna be no submitment is not required at this time. First we'll be rated, blades are on, and first to turn we continue underway. The procedure will be via SID. Let's go ahead and
are you ready
this.
For the departure brief?
Go ahead.
Okay, it's going to be a standard pushback and start off the gate. Taxi route will be as assigned by ATC. It'll be a left seat takeoff, using rated thrust. Planning a flaps 5 takeoff. Anti-ice will be off. Above 80 knots, we will reject for fire, engine failure, loss of control, or wind shear. The crew member noticing the abnormality will clearly state the problem. I will call reject or continue. If the decision is to reject, I will close the thrust levers and disengage auto throttle, observe or apply maximum braking, raise speed brakes, apply maximum amount of reverse thrust consistent with conditions and bring the aircraft to a complete stop on the runway, stow the speed brake, and set the parking brake, advise the cabin, This is the captain speaking. Remain seated, remain seated. I'll then perform any necessary memory items or checklists as appropriate. If an evacuation is required, I'll initiate the evacuation checklist. In the event of an engine failure after V1, we will continue the takeoff, rotate at VR, call positive rate gear up, and cancel the master caution. There will be no other calls below 400 feet. At 400 feet, I'll call for a roll mode, then call confirm the failure. If required, we'll perform any necessary memory items, climb at V2 to V2 plus 20 to 1,000 feet AFL or TOCA, whichever is higher. Retract flaps on schedule. When flaps have been retracted at or above flaps up maneuver speed, call for level change if VNAV is not engaged. Set max continuous thrust and call for the appropriate emergency checklist. We are under our maximum landing weight, so we are okay to make an immediate return. The departure routing will be via the ATC assigned SID, complying with all published speeds and altitude restrictions. No noise abatement procedures required. LNAV and VNAV are armed. Flight directors are on. Mine is master, yours is slave. Navigation radios are set. The NOTAMs and the aircraft defect logs have been reviewed. Any questions, comments, or concerns?
No questions.
Departure brief complete.
Visibility, tree. Sky condition, cue clouds at 1,800 feet, cue clouds at 4,900 feet, cue clouds at 14,200 feet. Temperature, 2 tree. Dew point, 10. Altimeter, 29er, decimal, 901.
Ascension ground, chase 1 with Victor ready to taxi IFR.
Chase 1 taxi 2 and hold short of runway 20 via taxiway Alpha. Contact tower on 118.1 when ready.
Taxi 2 and hold short runway 20 via taxiway Alpha Chase 1.
Okay, so 20. All right, so the departure briefing is complete. Let's go ahead and...
Hi guys, here's the load sheet for you.
Thanks.
No problem, have a safe flight.
Hey guys, all packs are on board. Are we clear to close?
Yes.
Thanks. Let me know if you need anything.
Let's prepare for the pushback. Okay, ready for pushback. Alright. Before start checklist.
Flight deck door closed and locked. MCP.
V2146 heading 206 altitude 12,000.
Takeoff speeds.
V1133, V-rotate 135, V2146.
CDU pre-flight.
Completed.
Rudder and aileron trim.
3 and 0.
Taxi and takeoff brief.
Completed.
Anti-collision light on. Before start checklist complete.
Start sequence is going to be 2 and then 1.
Check. Check.
Start sequence is 1 and then 2.
Check.
all work.
It is our policy that you keep your seatbelt fastened at all times while seated. Doors are clearly marked with exit signs and instructions for door operation. Each door is equipped with an escape slide. Locate the exit nearest you at the nearest exit.
Parking brakes are released. Start engine number one.
Start engine one.
Cover your nose and mouth.
Oil pressure.
Place the elastic band around your head and tighten by pulling on the end. Secure your own mask before assisting others. Your seat bottom cushion may be used as a flotation device. Pull up and remove the cushion upon exiting the aircraft. Place your arms around the cushion and hold on to the straps located on the back. This is a non-smoking flight. Smoking is not permitted in the cabin or laboratory. Cabin lights will now be turned off. Reading light buttons are located above your seat. Thank you for your attention.
Starter cut out. Number one stable.
Start engine number two.
Start engine two. Oil pressure.
Hey, parking brake set.
Waiting your confirmation for a good engine start.
Okay.
Starter cut out. Number two stable.
All right, good engine start.
Cockpit to ground. We have a good engine start. You can disconnect.
Flight control check complete. Flaps 5. Before taxi checklist.
Before taxi checklist. Generators on. Probe heat on. Anti-ice off. Isolation valve auto. Engine start switches continuous. Recall.
Checked.
Checked. Auto brake. RTO. Engine start levers.
Idle detained.
Flight control.
Checked.
Ground equipment.
Clear.
Clear. Before taxi checklist completed.
Clear left.
Clear right.
Let's go.
Flight deck. Okay, thanks. Captain, the cabin is secure.
And... Okay, we made a mistake here. And we got the wrong turn. So we're gonna be using Delta here. Back to Charlie.
Approaching 2-0. On runway 2-0.
We're gonna exit here via Charlie. We can get on Bravo Alpha. Let's go here right onto Bravo. Okay, let's perform a quick before takeoff checklist.
Before takeoff checklist. Flaps.
Flaps 5, green light.
Stabilizer trim.
4.8 units.
Before takeoff checklist completed.
Approaching Zero Tower.
Chase 1 ready for departure.
Approaching
runway 20 IFR
zero,
to Azizah.
2.
Chase 1 altimeter 29er, decimal 91.
Runway anti-procedural.
Cleared for takeoff runway 20.
Okay, cabin crew, take your seats. Clear on the approach.
Cleared for takeoff runway 20, Chase 1.
Ready to go.
On runway 02.
Take off.
Thrust set.
Airspeed's alive.
80 knots.
Check.
B1. Rotate.
B2.
Positive rate.
Yeah.
Positive rate.
Gear up. Feet.
Flaps 1.
Speed check.
Flaps up.
Flaps 1,
good
set. Speed check. Flaps up, set.
Ascension Center, Chase 1, is passing 2,700 feet, climbing 12,000 feet.
After takeoff checklist.
After takeoff checklist. Engine bleeds on. Pads. Auto. Landing gear. Up and off. Flaps up, no lights. After takeoff checklist complete.
Altimeter setting.
Happy to release the cabin crew.
Okay.
Okay.
Transition set standard.
Standard set. Passing flight level 060. Now.
flight level 100.
Chase 1 climb and maintain flight level 240.
Happy to release the cabin?
Okay.
Climb and maintain okay. flight level 240, Chase 1.
Portable electronic devices may now be used, with the exception of TVs, radios, two-way transmitters, or any other device in the transmit mode, as these devices may interfere with the aircraft's communication and navigation systems.
Pilot on.
Alright, pretty good takeoff there.
1,000 to level.
Thank you. Marvel 301. trabajando libre 146.
Resistencia Center, Chase 1 flight level 240.
Chase
1
Resistencia Center radar contact. Continue to repound.
Argentina 149, truco. Muy buenos días. La resistencia del sol salió muy bajo su comunicación. 7-0. Recibido, me confirma la hora que estima su despegue y control de acción en directa.
Muy buen día, Argentina 1-4-5, posición 1-0. 2-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3- L1, how can I help you?
One coffee, please. One coffee, please.
Hi guys, here are the drinks.
Thanks. You have control.
I have control.
I don't know whether to do or not.
Bear at Flight of Ultra 380 front 406.
Are you ready for the approach brief?
Okay.
The arrival routing will be via the ATC assigned star, complying with all published speeds and altitude restrictions. For an ILS approach, planning a flaps 30 landing. Final approach fix altitude is 2,200 feet. Decision altitude is 2,600 feet. Missed approach altitude is 3,000 feet. Taxi route in will be as assigned by ATC. We'll be arriving at a gate. Descent speeds and navigation radios are set. Airport NOTAMs have been reviewed. Any questions, comments, or concerns?
No questions.
Approach brief complete.
Set course my side. Set course my side. 351.
351. Set.
Set course your side. 351.
351. Set.
Set heading. 351.
351. Set.
I have control.
You have control.
Right, so we will be descending in about 200 nautical miles. Let's get the latest weather.
Thank you.
aeropuerto respecto a de
Cuatro, cinco, dos, cinco, cero, para 200, estamos a 10 a 10. rock.
Tucumán, contigo,
Descent checklist.
Descent checklist. Pressurization. Landing altitude is 50 feet. Recall. Check. Auto brake. Level 3. Landing data.
VROF 145. Minimums 267 feet.
VREF 145. Minimums 267 feet. Approach briefing.
Completed.
Descent checklist completed.
So it's flight level 140.
Flight level 140 set.
So just in about less than 15 nautical miles, we're going to be starting our descent. No, that's the 17 nautical miles then. If the ATC will not instruct us to start our descent, we're going to be requesting a descent by 10,000 feet.
Center fuel pumps off.
This is 10,000 feet. Okay, so descend now 10,000 feet. Chart.
runway 35 in use. Landing altitude
Maybe we can see the airport we're gonna be landing at. Yes. Or not? No, it's not. Let's see. Airport. No, it's not the airport we're gonna be landing at.
1000 to level.
Good day.
112 decimal niner.
Going to 119 decimal niner, chase one.
119. Hey. 119 decimal niner.
Isa approach, chase 110,100 feet.
Chase 1 is Isa approach altimeter 30.03 radar contact. Continue to Echo Zulu Echo.
Continue to Echo Zulu.
Descend and maintain 5,000 feet.
Descend and maintain 5,000 feet.
Descend and maintain 5,000 feet, chase 1.
Oh, 124
decimal
5.
124 decimal 5. Chase
Cabin
one.
Crew, prepare for landing.
Goodbye. 124 decimal 5. Chase 1. Goodbye.
Yeah, so now they're gonna close around like that. Right. So 119 decimal niner.
Height checked. Missed approach altitude is not set.
Set missed approach altitude.
3,000. Set. Flight deck. Okay, thanks. Captain, the cabin is secure.
Thanks.
Isa Tower, chase 110 miles, southeast inbound ILS Zulu runway, tree fight approach.
Chase 1, Isa Tower. Altimeter
30.02
and 0 tree niner at 4.
Cleared ILS Zulu runway
35
approach.
Cleared ILS Zulu runway
35
approach, chase 1.
Transition set altimeter 1017 set.
One, zero, one, seven, set, passing, 3,200. Now, 1,000 to level. Radio altimeter alive. Cabin crew, take your seats.
Set heading 351.
351 set.
Hey Wolf, how are you today?
Check.
Sorry. Approach checklist.
Approach checklist. Altimeters?
1017 set.
1017 set. Approach checklist completed.
Set Mr. Approach altitude
3,000 set.
No, I'm not using any couriers programs from my theme. I do have like list of places I want to visit, like the entire world with the 737 at least. But currently we are in South America, so that after that we're gonna do the Africa region. Let's arm the approach. Flaps 5.
Speed check. Flaps 5 set.
Gear down.
Gear down.
Flaps 15.
Speed check.
Speed break up.
Flaps 15 set.
Flaps 30.
Speed check. Flaps 30 set.
Landing checklist.
Landing checklist. Engine start switches.
Continues.
Speed brake.
Armed.
Landing gear.
Down.
Flaps.
Flaps 30 green light.
Landing checklist completed. Autopilot off.
Clear to land runway 35, Chase 1.
Feet stable. Feet.
Four hundred. 300.
Approaching minimums.
Approaching minimums. 200. Minimums.
Minimums. Minimums.
Continue.
50 40 30 20 10. Speed break up.
First is one.
That was firm.
Disarm.
Okay to clean up. Okay to clean up.
Roger.
Yeah, so the landing was firm at 332 FPM. Could have done better, but that's all right. Okay, let's connect the ground.
Check.
Zyza ground, Chase. One request taxi to the gate.
Chase one taxi to gate 19er via taxiway.
Well, that's very detailed.
APU on the buses.
Via taxiway.
Taxiing to gate 19er via taxiway, Chase 1.
19er. One niner. All right, let's figure out where is this one niner is. Parking spots. 19er, 19er. Where is it? 19er. You know what? I see it. Okay. Let's go. I'm gonna be using this one. I'm gonna take a right here. Ah, thank you very much, Wolf.
3 minutes.
Ah, 3 minutes, that's good. Lights and doors.
Check. Cabin crew disarm doors and cross check.
Engines are shut. And let's go ahead and connect the ground power. Ground power is requested. The parking was not bad.
Check.
Shutdown checklist.
Shutdown checklist. Fuel pumps off. Crowby off. Hydraulic panel set. Flaps
up.
Parking brake
released.
Engine start levers.
No fly. Well, you know what? I'm gonna check it out. See what it's all about. Is this like a career software? All right, let's shut the radios. Secure the aircraft. Let's go ahead and start all the boarding procedures as well. I'm gonna check this later out later today to see what it's all about. And okay, so for the record, we need to display our landing rate, landing stats. Okay, so we're gonna synchronize it with our my profile there. Let's see the average. Okay, so my average is about 204 feet per minute. Pretty good. I'd say it started about with 300, I guess, I think so. 350, I think so, since I started using the software. Okay, okay, okay. Secure the aircraft. Say again.
Engine start levers.
Cut off.
Weather radar.
Off.
Off. Shutdown checklist completed.
Secure the aircraft. Secure checklist.
Secure checklist. IRS off. Emergency exit lights off. Window heat off. PACS off. Secure checklist complete.
Okay. Secure checklist is complete. And this is it for our flight for today. Thank you very much for joining, Wolf. I would much appreciate if you could like and subscribe to my channel and follow me on Twitch. If you like my liveries, you are more than welcome to download them in the link in the description below on the YouTube channel. And follow me on Facebook for livery updates as well. I usually post there too if there is something to update. Thank you very much, and I hope to see you on my next stream.